Now, I will show you on how to create filter based on alphabet character. This one, if I select A, it will filter accordingly. If I select also here L, so whatever the names with begin with letter L, it shows in our list box. Look here also, if we will filter by subject, it will show also. Then show on. Okay, now I will show you on how to create one by one. Okay, now let's start. I will close this database and we will create the new one. Here I will click this icon, then blank. I will go to desktop, then alphabetical filter. You can put whatever name you want, then create. Next, I will click this create, then table design. I will type student ID 02, then next first name, then last name, then subjects. This primary key, I will copy this first name and I will put in caption. I will put space here also, last name, caption, then space. I will click or press Ctrl S to save. Then I will put the name student, name of this table. First name, subjects. Next, I will create another table. Then I will type letters, because we will put our alphabet here. Then I will save alphabet. Then next, I will go to create. Then I will click this form design to create a form. I will press right click, then form header. I will press Ctrl S to save, then FRM students. Student. I will change the back color to red. I will type the hex code. Then B A, then 1419. This is the red color. I will go to design and I will add combo box. filter by subject. I will rename this one to CBO subjects. So this is the name of our combo box. The next, I will go to design, then I will add here list box for our student's name. Student or name of students. I will copy this color for color, then border I will also change to red, then style or special effect I will choose shadow effect, border color shadow. Then I will rename this list box to LST students. So here data, our record source is students. I will select this form, then go to design, then add existing. So I will add this I will delete this one. I will modify I will copy the color for I will change to at least 14, then layout stack. Why I delete before? Because if I select all, so I need to modify all the format. So by using this one, I already layout, I make it stuck. So if I go to here design, add existing, if I put here, automatically it will, whatever the format of the student ID, it will copy also. So no need to preformat. So I will size tallest, then I will select this one, then arrange, I will remove the or narrow padding, then another size tallest. Okay, so again this form are record source students. So here we need to make or create the query for our resource for this list box. Now we will go to create, then query design. I will double click this students. I will double click also this student ID. Then here, since this first name and last name is separate, so we will put here in our list the full name. So we'll combine the first name and last name. So we will concatenate those fields. I will type full name, then bracket, then I will type last name, then close bracket, and then double quote, comma, double quote, and then open bracket, then first name, then close bracket. Here we will make us ascending, and I will drag these students. Then I will save this query, students extended. So this is the name of our query, student extended. So in order to show that if these are queries working, so I need to add some or list for our students. I have already prepared list of students. Here I'll just select this blank. Why I need to select this blank? Because as you can see in our table here, students ID, this is auto number, so meaning whatever we enter, automatically it will generate the number incrementally. So since we will copy this list, so we need to include this blank in order to offset this ID. I will copy, then select, then paste. So automatically it will generate the number. Then here also alphabet, no need to copy the blank because it's already a single column, so just copy all, then paste. I will make it simple. Again, look, it's combined our list of students, first name and last name, combined as a full name. So this is our records source or row source for this list box, LST students row source. Then I will paste the students, then well view, look, it's showing the ID. suppose here this is suppose will show. So this is column 0, column 1 and column 2. So we need to modify our column here. Just select, then go to format, column, we need to change to 3 because there this is 3 column. Then since this we need this only this one, so we need to hide this column 0 and column 2. How? And this is column 1. Here column width, since the column count is 3, so the first one, which is the student ID, we will hide by putting 0 for width, then double quote, I mean colon, semicolon rather, then I will put 1.5 for our full name, then semicolon, then I will put also 0 to hide the subjects. Look again, this one we make 0, and this one we make 1.5, and this one will make 0 in order to hide and only showing this volume. Look, now showing the full name. Next,